welcome to Tippecanoe Valley High School for tonight's varsity matchup between the Tippecanoe Valley Vikings and the Rochester Zebras. I'm Chris Seacrest, and you're watching an RTC Channel 4 presentation of Indiana High School basketball. Let me tell you, folks, we got a good one on our hands here tonight. Tippecanoe Valley coming in this game 14-4, Rochester coming in 9-9. Both these teams in the Three Rivers Conference, and Hannah Dunn will score first for Tippecanoe Valley. We got a packed house here tonight for this one. A much anticipated matchup. Valley coming in this game after losing to Northwood 50-41. Hannah Dunn for two, and she'll get that one. Valley with an early 4-0 lead. Addie Miller going to get called for her first foul. That one going to be taken away by Sophie Buzzard. Buzzard shooting for two. That one going to go in and out. Both these teams wanting a victory here. For Rochester, getting a victory would be a huge lift for them as they're sitting at 500. For Valley, a win here will just be some more bragging rights. That one goes out of bounds. Of course, this is a big rivalry. And all the sports here, Tippecanoe Valley and Rochester. Hannah Dunn inside, goes to the ground. Valley will keep the ball. And Seacrest going inside looking for two, and she's going to get it. Valley up to a 6-0 run now. Broyette not able to take that one away. That shot, I don't even know if you can classify that as a shot, but nonetheless, Valley has the ball. Addie Miller going to shoot a three. Not able to make it. Buzzard gets the rebound. Buzzard will put it up. That's no good. Valley still with the ball. Buzzard puts it up again, and that time she'll make it. And Rochester calls a timeout as Tippecanoe Valley is leading 8-0. 5:18 to go here in the first. Rochester will have the ball. They're down by 8. Valley dominating so far. Seacrest just going to take that one away. Going inside, finding Broyette. Broyette going up. That no good. Rochester will rebound. That's going to be a foul there on Sophie Buzzard. That'll be her first. Morgan Ruff made that one for the Zebras. And she'll miss the second one. Seacrest on the rebound. Hannah Dunn inside. That's going to be a foul there. Valley leading here, 8-1. Addie Miller going inside. I'll have another foul. Valley still with the ball. And Seacrest looking inside. No good. Now I'm going to sail out of bounds. It'll go back to the Vikings. Hannah Dunn for two, no good. Seacrest. That's going to be a jump ball call. And it's going to go to the Zebras. Who can forget 2 years ago when Valley played Rochester in the semi-state game? Valley moving on, went to the state championship after beating the Zebras 60-45. Hopefully we can have that same result here tonight. Three-point attempt is up, no good. Buzzard on the rebound. Boyette going inside, looking for two, no good. Seacrest, that's going to be a jump ball. And it's going to stay with the Vikings. Bad pass there by Seacrest. Dunn was double covered. Dunn trying to get it back, and it's going to roll out of bounds. And they're going to give it to Valley. Valley still leading here, 8-1. Hannah Dunn inside, looking for a place to go. And Seacrest shooting. Oh, that's going to be called for a travel there. Seacrest going to take that one away. Finds Buzzard. Buzzard will put it up. Oh, tough luck there. But she'll put it back up. No good. Hannah Dunn going to get it now. And Valley will have another chance. Miller inside, lobbing it up there, no good. It's going to be a foul on Hannah Dunn. That'll be her first. Emily Peterson comes in for Valley, as does Asia O'Connor. Three-point attempt, no good. Peterson on the rebound. Finds Sechrist. Sechrist going up. And someone got in there, got a hand on it, but Valley will still have the ball. Of course, the Rochester cheer block, very excited about that one, but you got to look at the scoreboard sometimes and realize you're down. Mishap there. Peterson lost it. .150 to go now here in the first. Valley still leading by 7. And I don't know what kind of shot that was. She ran into the brick wall known as Ann Sechrist and didn't get anything out of it. Sophie Buzzer going inside, finding O'Connor. Buzzard inside, looking for 2, and she'll get it. That'll give Buzzard 4 points on the night as Valley will now lead 10-1. Peterson took that one away. She's got to find a place to go. Finds Buzzard. Buzzard going up again, and Buzzard will get 2. That's 6 points now for Buzzard. Well, that's going to be a foul there on Meredith Broyette. That'll be her first. Valley leading 12-1. Under a minute to go here in the first. Valley with a full court press. That's going to be a foul on O'Connor. That'll be O'Connor's first foul. And that's going to be going the other way. .40 to go in the first quarter. Valley leading 12-1. And Sechrist for 2, no good. That's going to be a foul on O'Connor again. Olivia Tripedi will come in now for the Vikings. Valley leading by 11, under 20 seconds to go in the first quarter. That's going to be a foul on Olivia Tripedi. That'll be her first, 11 seconds to go. Morgan Ruff at the line for the Zebras. And she'll make that one. Seems like the Zebras only able to get points off free throws so far in this one. Valley's defense must just be too hard for them. Valley leading 12-3. Few seconds to go here in the first quarter. Peterson tried shooting, and that's going to be a foul. And Peterson will head to the charity stripe. Peterson will make the first one. Valley leading by 10. 1.4 on the clock. And Peterson will make them both. And Rochester will have time for one final shot. She tosses it up. No good. And at the end of one quarter, Tippecanoe Valley leading 14-3 over the Zebras. Rochester will have the ball to start the second quarter of play. Valley leading 14-3. Rochester only been able to get their points off free throws. Sophie Buzzer going to get called for the foul. That'll be her second. Morgan Ruff at the line. She'll make that one. And again, Rochester only able to get points from the line. Boryek kind of come back in for the Vikings. Valley still leading by 10. Ruff will make the second one. It'll be interesting to see if the Zebras can get double digits before halftime as Meredith Boyette will make a three. That'll put Valley up 17-5. Tripedi gonna take that one away. Good job there by Tripedi. Peterson gonna go in and back out. Peterson gonna shoot for two now. That's gonna be no good. Miller on the rebound, finds Boyette. Boyette for three again, no good off the back. Peterson will get it this time. And now Valley will take a breather here after that little fiasco. Bad pass there by Sechrist as that one taken away. Sechrist is trying to find Miller on the outside. Three-point attempt, no good. Tripedi going to come up with it. That one goes out of bounds. Bad call there, in my opinion. I don't know what the ref saw, but obviously he didn't see what everyone else saw. Three-point attempt up, no good. And that'll go in for number 22, Allie Harsh. First time Rochester has made a field goal there. Tripedi for two, no good. Valley leading 17-7. Rochester will call a timeout as Tippecanoe Valley leading 17-7, 5:45 to go here in the first half. Valley leading 17-7. They've dominated Rochester in the first quarter. And they're doing the same here so far in the second. Three-point attempt up, no good. Miller on the rebound. Tripedi finds Sechrist inside. That's going to be a foul there. Valley will still have the ball. That'll be the third foul there for Morgan Ruff, and Rochester's coach will take her out. And Sechrist inside, looking for two, no good. Just over 5 minutes to go here in the first half. Valley leading by 10. Valley all over him. Tripedi gonna come up with it. Peterson is inside and she'll get two. That'll give Valley 19 points. That'll be 4 points for Peterson on the night. Now we're gonna roll out of bounds. It'll go back to the Vikings. Peterson for three, no good. Miller on the rebound. Miller finds Tripedi, but Tripedi couldn't hold on to it. The ball's loose. The ball's loose. Rochester's still able to hold on to it. Now it's loose again, and Broyette going to take it. Broyette shooting for two, and that's going to bank in. That'll give Valley a 21-7 lead, just under 4 minutes to go here in the first half. That's going to be a foul on Ann Sechrist. That'll be her first foul of the night. Number 34, Karina Peterson, not able to make that. Miller for three. No good off the back. Dunn on the rebound. Dunn goes up. No good. Sechrist able to get it now. Finds Miller. Miller finds Dunn. Dunn finds Sechrist. And that's going to be a foul. Miller for three, no good. Sechrist gonna come up with it now. That's gonna be a foul. Sechrist is at the charity stripe for the Vikings. She'll make the first one. Valley leading 22-7, 3:05 to go here in the first half. Sechrist will make them both. That's going to be a travel call there, and it'll go back to the Vikings. And Valley going to take a timeout. Valley leading 23-7, 2:54 to go here in the first half. Valley with the ball. 2:50 to go here in the first half. Seacrest shoots a two. No good. Rochester hasn't been able to get anything going. Meredith Boryak going to take that one away. She's going to go up. No good. Just rolled off. Peterson puts it up. No good. That's going to be a foul there on Rochester. And Peterson going to head to the line. Peterson not able to make the first one. Peterson will make the second. Valley now leading 24-7. Meredith Boyette going to be calling for her second foul. Olivia Tripedi. Never mind, they'll not send her in just yet. But Tripedi will be in after this shot. That shot no good. Macy Brown shooting for the Zebras. Olivia Tripedi now in. She'll make the second one. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. Valley leading 24-8. Be interesting to see if Valley can hold Rochester to single digits here. As far as points go, Peterson for three, and that's going to go in. That'll give Peterson 8 points on the night. Two-point attempt up, no good. Now we're going to go out of bounds. Rochester with the ball. Seacrest got a hand on that one, but she's going to be calling for the foul. That'll be her second foul of the night. First one good there by number 44, Kennedy Musselman. Asia O'Connor will come in for the Vikings. Musselman will make that one. Valley leading 27-10. 1:20 to go in the first half. Valley has dominated this game early on. Done inside. Valley able to keep it. Dunn almost lost it, but Peterson able to come up with it. Under 45 seconds to go. Valley just going to hold on the ball as long as they can. Under 30 now. Under 20. Hannah Dunn for two. No good. O'Connor couldn't get the rebound. Under 5 seconds. She's got to get it up. She does. Not able to make it. And at halftime, Tippecanoe Valley leading 27-10 over the Zebras. And we'll be right back after halftime. Valley will start off with the ball. Three-point attempt early, no good. That shot, no good. And Sechrist on the rebound. Buzzer going to get called for the travel there. Valley will have the, or excuse me, Rochester still with the ball. Three-point attempt is up. That one is good by number 12, Macy Brown. Zebras first to strike in this half as Hannah Dunn will make that two-pointer. Valley been using the full-court press all night. That one loose, and it'll be out of bounds off Miller. That one going to go out of bounds. And it's also going to be a foul on Addie Miller. That'll be her second foul of the night. That one going to be fumbled and given to Ann Sechrist. Miller for three, and that's good. Valley leading 32-13. Under six to go now in the third. Oh, lost the ball. That'll be a jump ball. And it's going to go to the Vikings. Dunn going inside now. Dunn going to get called for the travel. Loose ball again. Seacrest comes up with it. Finds Broyette. Miller thought about three, decided not to. Probably a good choice because Hannah Dunn right there inside. Hannah Dunn couldn't get it in. Rolled off there. Rochester trying to get something going, if anything. That shot good there, number 44, Kennedy Musselman. That shot attempt no good. Valley leading by 17. Broyette gonna take that one away, finds Miller. Miller going up, no good. And that's gonna be a foul. I believe that one is on Miller. That it will be. That'll be her third foul of the night. O'Connor and Peterson back in for the Vikings. Three-point attempt, no good. Broyette able to rebound, but it's going to be taken away. That shot attempt, no good. Buzzard on the rebound. Peterson thought about three, decided not to, and that pass broken up by the Zebras. Going to be a jump ball. It's going to go to Rochester. Three-point attempt, no good. That'll go out of bounds. Valley looking for something. That's going to be a kick ball. Three-point attempt by Buzzard, no good, overshot. Peterson able to get it back. Buzzard gonna go inside now. Finds Peterson on the outside, that's gonna be a two-pointer there. That's going to be a foul there on O'Connor. That'll be O'Connor's third foul of the night. Olivia Tripedi will come in. Valley leading by 19. That shot attempt, no good. Buzzard on the rebound. That'll be out of bounds there. Valley will have it. Seacrest lost the ball trying to go inside. And that'll result in 2 points for the Zebras. And Seacrest gonna head to the charity stripe. .201 to go here in the third. Valley leading 34-17. Make it 35-17. While the timeout on the court here, Tippecanoe Valley leading 35-17. 2:01 to go here in the third. And Seacrest is shooting for Valley. Valley leading 35-17, 2:01 to go here in the third. Seacrest will make it. Now we're gonna go out of bounds. That one out of bounds again. Rochester still with the ball. Three-point attempt, no good. Seacrest on the rebound. Buzzard will go up for two and she'll get it. Valley now leading 38-17. Three-point attempt is good there. Number 12, Macy Brown. Trapedi for three, that one no good. Under a minute now to go in the third. Valley leading 38-20. Rochester gonna hold for a final shot here to end the half, or excuse me, end the quarter. They're down by 18. The Valley cheer block being very obvious with their cheers. They're chanting boring. That, I don't even know if that was a shot attempt. Whatever it was bad. And it's going to be a foul on Broyette. That'll be her third. Hannah Dunn will come in. Final seconds. That's going to be a travel call. Valley will have the ball with 5.2 seconds to go here in the third quarter. And that'll give them just enough time to get off a shot. Addie Miller coming back in for the Vikings. Buzzard for three, not able to bank it in. And at the end of three, Tippecanoe Valley leading 38-20 over the Zebras. Valley will have the ball to start the fourth and final quarter. They're leading 38-20. Valley doing what Rochester did. Valley just letting the clock eat away. Now they've started something. That's going to be a travel call there on Hannah Dunn. Now we're going to go to bounds off Hannah Dunn. That shot attempt no good. Buzzard comes up with the ball. Sechrist inside. Peterson not going to shoot a three. Decides to go inside for two, and she'll get it. That shot attempt, no good. Sechrist comes up with it, able to stay in bounds. Dunn able to keep it in bounds, but Rochester is going to take it away. Valley leading by 20. 5:30 to go here in the game. Valley has dominated all game. That's going to be a foul. Addie Miller and Meredith Boyette will come back in for the Vikings. Boyette for three. No good. Dunn able to get the rebound. She'll put it up and get two. Nice job there by Hannah Dunn. Valley now leading by 22. Hannah Dunn going to take it. Finds Miller. Miller up. And that'll go in. Boyette takes it. That's going to be a foul. Boyette will go to the charity stripe for the Vikings. Boyette already has 5 points for Valley. Make that six. Tanisha Brown will come in for the Vikings for the first time tonight. That one in and out for Boyette. Brown with the rebound. Sechrist able to save it. Brown inside now. Finds Sechrist. Sechrist up. No good. And Rochester will have the ball. Two-point attempt, no good. Puts it back up, that is good. Number 44, Kennedy Musselman. Valley still leading by 23. Under four to go here in the game. Brown shoots for two, no good. That's going to be a foul there. That'll go back to the Vikings. With this lead that Valley has, it's very possible we could see number 40, Mackenzie Woodcox, come in for the Vikings. Primarily a JV player, she does tend to come in when Valley is up by a lot, as they are right now. Coach Kendick does like to use all the players on his varsity bench, and a three-pointer, though, they're going to count that as a two. Two-pointer there for Ann Sechrist. That's a long one for her. I've never seen Ann shoot a three-pointer. I was kind of hoping that would be one right there. That's going to be a 10-second violation. Valley will have the ball. Olivia Tripedi comes back in. Valley leading 47-22. 2:45 to go here in this one, and I have to say this one is all but over. Boyette for three, no good. Tripedi able to keep it. And Valley will have another opportunity here. Brown going inside now. looking for a place to go. And Brown going to be called for a travel. Asia O'Connor will now come in for the Vikings. Three-point attempt, no good. Brown on the rebound. Under two now to go in the game. Valley will just hold on to the ball. And we'll have a timeout on the court. Tippecanoe Valley leading here 47-22. 1:20 to go here in the game. Valley still with the ball. They're leading 47-22. This game all but over. Brown inside looking for points. Brown again going to be called for the travel. Mackenzie Woodcox is now in for the Vikings, and that means Valley has used every single player on their varsity bench. That is the fourth or fifth time they've done that this season. It's always good to see that you can put in all your players. Two-point attempt is up, and no good. Under a minute now, and this one is over. That shot attempt no good. Now they'll try again. That shot attempt no good, and O'Connor will come up with it. So Valley will move to 15-4 on the season. And they will remain undefeated in TRC play. And, of course, coming up is that big matchup against Witco on the 19th. That's going to be a travel call there again on Brown. 21 seconds to go now. Rochester will fall to 9-10. As fans are now starting to make their way out, and that's going to be 2 point there, and she'll head to the line. Number 40, Kenzie McKee, but it's not going to be enough. That one no good. They'll have another chance. Tripedi will come up with it. Final seconds, and that will be the end of the game. Tippecanoe Valley will win this one 47-24 over the Zebras. And well, that's the bottom line because the scoreboard says so. I'm Chris Sechrist, and you've been watching an RTC Channel 4 presentation of Indiana High School basketball. Good night, folks.